What happens when I mark something as spam? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question I got. When I report something as spam, what really happens to it? Does my email service know what to do with it if it ever shows up again? Is there any protection for me? Does the person who sent the email know that I put it in the spam folder? For reasons that I'll explain in a moment, there's really no definitive answer on exactly what happens. However, there are absolutely some general concepts that apply when you mark something as spam. The first thing we need to know is whether you're marking it as spam in an email program running on your computer or an email service you're visiting online in your browser. The answer for each turns out to be quite different. An email program is software that's running on your computer and downloads messages from your email service to your local hard disk. Examples might be Microsoft Office's Outlook, or Thunderbird, or the mail program included with Windows, now also confusingly called Outlook. There are dozens, if not hundreds, of others. When you mark something as spam, or junk as it's sometimes called, while using an email program, you're typically telling only that program on that computer that the message is unwanted. Particularly if your email account uses the POP3 protocol, the information about what you've marked as spam does not make its way back to your email service provider. The result is it doesn't affect what email will be downloaded in the future. It will affect what messages that email program on that PC will consider to be spam. Mobile devices have added a couple of twists on whether marking something as spam in a computer-based email program makes it back to the email service. Some email services now provide dedicated email programs. On my mobile phone, for example, is an app I use to access Gmail. Technically, that's an email program or app running on a computer, my phone. However, since it's dedicated to handling Google Mail, when I mark something as spam using the program, the information is transmitted back to Google servers. Similarly, I have the Outlook mobile app. When I mark something as junk in my Hotmail account, that information also makes its way back to Microsoft's server. Desktop email programs can use IMAP instead of POP3 to allow you to access your email from multiple different devices and keep everything in sync. IMAP does this by always considering the email on the server as the master copy. Each email program that connects using IMAP maintains a synchronized copy of your email on that device. Change, delete, or move email around in the folders on your PC, and those changes are reflected in the master copy. When you mark something as spam, some email programs simply move it into a spam or junk folder. If you're using IMAP, when that move is reflected on the server's master copy, that may be enough to notify the service that this message is spam. There are no blanket rules, and aside from dedicated apps like the Gmail and Outlook apps, it's difficult to make assumptions about how your email program works with your email service when it comes to spam. The best I can suggest there is to check the help information available for each. An email program, again, running on your device, may use the fact that you've marked something as spam in several different ways. It might add the sender's email list to a block list. This is a separate function in some email programs. Unfortunately, block lists based on email addresses are not effective in the war against spam. Spammers constantly change or fake their email addresses. It might add the IP address of the sender or the sender's email service to a block list. Once again, IP address-based blocking is not effective against spam. Spammers send from millions of different IP addresses. It might analyze the contents of the message and identify various characteristics of the message it then records as looking like spam to you. Incoming email with similar characteristics then might be automatically flagged as spam. This is the most common and currently the most effective email program-based spam filtering technique. As effective as it can be, the problem with looking for characteristics is that it's difficult to predict what does and does not constitute spam. You might get an email that is clearly spam to you, mark it as spam, and then later get another nearly identical message that was not filtered. These types of learning or adaptive filters don't act immediately. They build up statistical characteristics. The more email you identify as spam, the more those characteristics are updated. It might not be until the second or third or fourth or tenth time you mark a particular type of spam that the filter will have enough confidence to kick in and automatically identify similar messages as spam in the future. Similar is, after all, a very fuzzy concept. Great, your email program has identified something as spam. Now, what does it do with it? Most email programs do absolutely nothing more than move the email to a spam folder. That's it. Period. There's no notification back to the sender, no notification to the email service. Everything happened on your computer or your device, and only on your computer or your device. This type of spam filtering is nothing more than placing email detected as spam into a different folder as it's downloaded to your computer. At least it gets it out of your way. Now, if you're using a web browser, like Edge or Chrome or Firefox or others, to read your email, you're using an online email service. Your email is stored in the cloud, not on your PC, and you're simply viewing it via a web-based interface. Examples of web-based services include Outlook.com or Gmail or Yahoo Mail or many others. Your own ISP or email service provider may also have web-based interfaces for your email besides the services that allow you to download it to your PC. The important thing here is that you're using your web browser to interact with your email stored in your email services server online. When you mark something as spam in an online service, you're doing essentially the same thing you did above with a PC-based email program. You're telling the service, I think this email looks like spam. The difference is that every other user of that service is also telling the provider what they think is and is not spam. Now, exactly how the service uses that information is a mystery, and that's on purpose. They don't want spammers to learn the details of the mystery. That would make it easier for spammers to know how to work around it. Also, how service providers use that information is constantly changing in response to the ever-changing nature of spam. There are several approaches email service providers may or may not use. Things that you mark as spam are used to identify and filter spam only for you. This is basically the PC model at the server level. You're not impacted by the spam decisions of other users. Your marking something as spam goes into a single database used for everyone. Only things that everyone thinks look like spam are filtered. No matter how often you mark something as spam, if everybody else on the service treats it as legitimate, you may never see it filtered. Or hybrid, a combination of what everyone else thinks is spam plus what you think is spam is somehow used when filtering email destined for your inbox. My sense is that most providers use the hybrid approach, but as I said, it varies from provider to provider and it changes over time. Much like the email program on your PC, when a spam is filtered by an email service, it's moved to a spam folder in your account. You can usually safely ignore and/or periodically check the folder for false positives. Again, no notice is sent to the sender. The email has in fact been delivered. It's just been delivered to your spam folder. Some services take things a step further. Some services identify spam at a global level, perhaps based on content or source or something else, and block it from being delivered entirely. You never see it in your inbox or your spam folder. From your perspective, it's like the email was never sent. Now, in rare cases, very rare cases, the service may send a bounce message to the sender. Regardless of whether you use PC or web-based email, spam detection is an inexact and ever-changing science. We all see email that we consider to be spam, perhaps even obvious spam, delivered into our inbox. Mark it as spam and your email program or service will learn a little bit more about you considered to be spam. Occasionally, however, legitimate mail gets marked and filtered as spam. We call this a false positive. You can correct false positives. For anything filtered and placed into a spam folder, you can say, this is not spam. This is perhaps even more important than identifying spam. Once again, this teaches the email program or service that email like this should not be considered spam. This is an important step to take. Every so often, spend a few minutes in your spam folder looking for things that were filtered and should not have been. Mark those as not spam to reduce the chance of similar mail in the future also being accidentally filtered. Bottom line, mark spam as spam. If you find legitimate email in your spam folder, mark it as not spam. That's the most effective thing you can do overall to deal with spam. If a lot of email goes directly to your spam folder, and it is indeed all spam, that's the system working as it should. When working perfectly, only spam lands in your spam folder. There could be a lot of it, but that's where it goes. Everything else shows up in your inbox, and you only have to pay attention to that. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/5330. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.